Hi, I'm Fran.
Hi, I'm Luke.
And we're the Futuristic Polar Bears,
and you're watching Only the Beat.
Well, first time we all met separately, I think, myself and Luke. I'm Fran, by the way, this is Luke. Reese is at home in the studio, but the first time we met was about 10 years ago. DJing, we were both DJing at a party in London. We met Reese, we were at a gig in Wales, and the guy who came to pick us up in the hotel, Reese was sitting in the lobby, and I started speaking to him when we were talking about music, and we just came out of the studio that day. I think we just finished Circus Bells, one of the first versions of the redo of Circus Bells we did, and I brought him out to the car and let him have a listen to it. And two days later, we went home. I woke up. I was like, "We need to get Reese." I said, "This guy's insane. Like, so we need to get him." And he was like, "So I rang him up, and he was with his kids somewhere." And I was like, "Listen, I need to ask you something. Do you want to be a futuristic polar bear?" And he was like, "What is that?" I was like, "It's just this idea we've been playing with," and I kind of sold him on the thing. And at the time, I was like, "Look, I'm telling you, we all three of us together, give us 3 or 4 years, mate, and we'd be touring all over the world, and it's what we all wanted, and you know, here we are." It's one of those names, we printed it out, and we put it on flyers, and we put it on like kind of festivals, and we told a few people, and whether people liked it or didn't like it, the first thing everyone said was like, "Fucking hell, you're never going to forget that name." Sorry, I didn't mean to curse.
You're Irish.
People were like, you know, "You're not going to forget that name." And it's been one of those things. It's once people kind of hear the name, they
That's the first thing our manager said when he signed us. He was like, "I ain't going to forget that name."
Well, with three of us, it's quite weird because ideology behind this, everyone said to us, "There's no way this is going to work." And we found it's been the total opposite, hasn't it, mate? Because there's three of us, we never stop working, ever. We usually only DJ with two of us unless we've got huge gigs like Creamfields. But at the moment, the main thing is one of us is always at home in the studio. And it means that our studio continues to operate all the time. And we're always writing, and we're always moving forward musically as well. Producing by yourself, you have to try and know yourself that it's right. But if you've got two best friends that are as driven as you as well, you can get critical feedback from each other without having, you know, without annoying each other, upsetting each other, putting each other down, and it tends to drive you forward.
Yeah, we got an email from them on a Friday night, and it just went, "We really like this track, we want to sign it." The day Reese got married, we were at his wedding, and our manager sent us over the video that Hardwell had just played it. And we all watched it after he just got married, and we were like, "Wow," but we couldn't do anything with it until January this year. And but that kind of helped to the kind of hype of the track. And that's the great thing about Revealed and Hardwell's team. They know how to work a track, and they know how to, you know, get the best mileage out of a track and create that hype and that buzz. It was a hard thing to sit on for 3 months. We've got some good collabs on the way, actually. We just finished one with Sultan and Ned. That's coming out next year. We've been road testing it on this tour. What else have we got coming up? We've got a new one with John Dish we've just finished, another one with Kill the Buzz we're just road testing at the minute, and then we're writing some new solo stuff as well, a couple of new vocal tracks and a couple of tougher stuff as well that will follow up to Back to Earth. So plenty going on in the studio at the minute, and yeah, we've been road testing about 4 or 5 of them on this tour, so we've been writing some different bits at the minute that, you know, it still tell it's our polar bear sound, but we're just, you know, trying, you know, new things and kind of new ways how to capture the audience and capture the crowd and stuff. So yeah, next 6 months to a year is going to be really, really interesting, I think, definitely.